Hello collectors, Joe Prodzik here with another episode of the Unboxing Experience. You know, I thought I was going to be working on some reviews for you this weekend, but it turns out my ARH, a Death Dealer 1 or Death Dealer on Horse, finally decided to show up. If you watched the last episode of Statue Talk, I mentioned that I had received two of the three boxes from ARH Studios, and the third box was making its way around California somewhere. At one point it was in Murphy's, couldn't be delivered in Murphy's because I don't live in Murphy's. Then it went down to Southern California. I don't live in Southern California either. So after a couple of weeks, finally showed up at my door. So this statue came in three big boxes. The first two actually came strapped together in one shipment, and the third, after bouncing around California, came on its own. Now, this boxing is going to be a little bit different because the statue's in three big boxes, because I've taken them out of the cardboard already, because I needed to see what was inside before I did the unboxing. I can't have three giant boxes sitting here and opening them all at the same time, so I took them out of the shipper boxes. ARH Studios does not yet have art boxes, so I took them out of the shipper boxes so I could see what was inside each box, so then I could open them and put the statue together accordingly. So I've already looked inside to see if anything was broken, and while I haven't taken everything out yet, it does so far look like there are no breaks. If you watched my last unboxing of ARH Studios Arion City of Horrors and you read some of the comments, you may know that some people aren't too high on ARH Studios. The company did have some troubles getting all their statues shipped out recently, but they are coming. I'm not willing to quite recommend that you order statues from this company. I want you to go do some research on them and make your own decision. For me, the two statues that I've ordered are now here. Sure, they went through a really long delay, but what statue doesn't? The only problem, I think, is that this statue has been in stock for 6 to 8 months, and I'm probably one of the last people to get this, so it is a frustrating wait for me. Well, ARH Studios is also not known for the best customer service. Yes, they are a really small company, and shipping out all the statues that they received at the same time is very challenging. And they only have a couple employees, so sometimes it does take them a while to respond to emails. Personally, they've always responded to all of my emails. I've never had a problem getting a hold of them. I've never had a problem having them respond to me. So some collectors have had that problem. I would say their customer service does need to improve. If you're a small company, you can't just say, I'm a small company, I can't have good customer service. No, you can have a small company, have delays on your stuff, just be outspoken about it, keep your customers informed, and stay positive with all your dealings and interactions with your customer. I do hope that ARH Studios gets on the right track and they can start producing a lot more statues again. I think what had happened is when they released this series of statues, they thought they were going to do a lot better than they did, and they had planned accordingly. And when they didn't do so good, kind of all started to fall apart a little bit. But the company is starting to rebound from that. They're making their statues in-house right now. So they're printing and painting their own pieces directly there at the studio. Where else are you going to get a handcrafted piece like that without going through some custom maker? And they are making a lot of statues that other companies aren't producing, like Greek gods and myths and Leonidas and historical figures and Medusa, and even their own statues like Arion and Arcala and different things like that. So it is still an interesting company. I do hope they start to do better. Now, if you'd asked me, you know, a year ago, this statue here, Death Dealer 1, Death Dealer on Horse, would have been near the top of my list for most anticipated pieces. But that did change a little bit when I started to worry and think, well, am I even gonna get this statue? But I've always loved Frank Frazetta's art. I've always known about the Death Dealer on horse art. And it's always been one of my favorite pieces. I've always, you know, been intrigued by the character, and I've always liked that sort of dark and gritty look. And when unboxing this statue, it does look a little bit like it's snowing out in my living room, because the styrofoam, I always say that, styrofoam is a brand name. Polystyrene is what the material is called. So it's not the highest quality polystyrene, so it is, does look like it's snowing out here in California right now. I don't know if the camera's picking up, but you see it on my clothes already. So, but the boxes themselves were reinforced a little bit differently than they have been in the past. And then the inserts that they're putting inside the box are a softer material rather than this kind of stiff and brittle. Stiff but brittle. Stiff but, you know, it's dense, but it falls apart pretty easily. Inside the box itself, the little inserts in there are more a less dense material. It's squishy, so that when you do have impacts and this box is jiggling around traveling up and down the state, it's going to be less likely to squeeze together the pieces, and it's going to have more suspension for the statue. Now, I wasn't expecting this, but I actually did get a Death Dealer art print with this statue. I thought only the New York Comic Con exclusive version of this statue had the art print, but I guess I was wrong, because I got it too. So that's gonna look really good. I'll plan on framing that along with the Arion art print I have and using them in the background of my display. I do already have a spot picked out for him. He got this big spot down here below Akuma, where I was planning on putting my ARH pieces. Now, without further ado, let's get this guy open. All right, box number one, you gotta start with the base. And yes, inside here is just the base. This guy is gonna be a monster. So look how long this box is already. About 32 and a half inches. It'll be a little bit smaller than that inside. So let's work on getting this out. Okay, see, here are the softer inserts I was talking about. Got a couple here. Now I'm gonna do my best to show off this whole statue, because my room is so small lengthwise and the statue is so big. Might have a hard time fitting the whole thing in the frame. I'll make sure to snap some pictures and snap some videos at different angles for you as well. All right, so I might need to put this box on the floor and then lift the base up to the table. I think that's the smart way to do it. All right, I'll let you take a look at that giant base in the box. Wow. I'm wondering now if I should put my turntable down. Spin them around a little bit. I know the base is gonna be a lot bigger than this, but this is just a cheap piece of plastic. So I'm not sure he's gonna be able to spin on that, but let's give it a go. So this is kind of heavy, right? Oh, it looks like I got number 2 out of 190. Low number, wow. All right, so I think, because we got the ARH Studios logo here, so I think that usually goes in the back. So yeah, looks like he is gonna be able to spin. I wonder if he'll spin on the electronic turntable so I can do my review. So here's the bass. It is not as heavy as it could be. It's still not light. You can hear some hollowness in there, but it honestly, between the shipping costs and moving this thing around, how heavy do you want it to be? It's a good weight. Got several skulls all around it. Lots of nice blood on it. Now let me go get the next box. All right, collectors, box number two. Like I said, it's gonna be a little bit challenging to unbox this guy. Such a small space. But as you can see, if I can get a good angle on that, this is the box with the horse. This is the box that was floating around up and down California. That's pretty heavy. I'm gonna get winded during this review. Oh. Gonna have to, all right. Let me just put this box on the floor, take the pieces out of there, put them up on the base. So we've got a couple smaller pieces here that I'm gonna dig out. They look like heads. So Sachi's gonna have two heads. Really is snowing here in California. I'm gonna have to vacuum up my living room and my statue room after this. So there's the first head there. It's in focus. Looks pretty cool. Digging it. And should have head number two here. This one has horns. They are a little bit different. One has metal horns, one has like animal horns. The eyes are a little bit different too on these. This one here on your left is a little bit more of a squint, and then it has a bit of yellow to it, while the other one is a little bit more rounder, and then has less yellow to it. Kind of like the animal horn one a little bit better. All right. And we have another little piece here. Yeah. Which looks like it's gonna be a little horsey's tail. Get that dusted off. I need a snow plow, snow shovel to get rid of all this foam. And then I'm gonna get the horse out. Gotta be real careful here. Oh, that is heavy. Wow. Gotta be careful with this one. Whew. See if I can get his legs out. Whew, I could have sure used Kwong's help for this unboxing. He is has his sister visiting from out of town, so he couldn't make this unboxing, and I didn't want to wait. I didn't want to wait around for him. I really wanted to see this guy. All right, so get that plastic out. His feet. And then it looks like... Nope. I'm gonna need the switches in. Better off switching the horse. Alright. This horse is big and heavy. He does have some little pieces on his underside. Alright, so he doesn't have any pegs, but he does have a little spot. Little spots for his feet, kind of little divots that are on the base. Does have some smaller pieces with the rings hanging down from his belt. Has some leather straps here. Has like, my wife would kill me for not knowing this. My wife and daughter take horseback riding lessons every week. So I want to say his bridle down here. That looks to be not material, but sculpted. So, yeah, can you see my shirt? How snowy I am? Look how snowy this horse is. Whew. Looks like the statue made it here okay, and I was really worried about this particular piece because this one was the one running up and down the state. So I'm gonna have to spend a little bit of time with my handy dandy snow shovel getting this guy off, and then I will bring in box number 3 and put Death Dealer himself on the horse. All right, collectors, I've got box number 3 here in my hands. I can't really move it and show it to you because this horse is taking up a lot of space. So again, under the table it's gonna go. And you can see me now. And I'm here. Alright, so you're gonna notice still a lot of spots of foam on this horse. You're gonna notice all over me. You're gonna notice it all over my table. I'm trying to blow it out in a direction that's away from the rest of my statues, because it's like some weird alien virus in here with all this foam. I'm surprised Mulder and Scully aren't here investigating. But since this part of my collection is open, I'm trying to blow all this foam this way, away from the open part of the collection. So if you see some white spots here or there, it's likely foam. And the biggest thing, and it looks like the statue arrived safe and sound and okay. And the biggest thing is that this cheap foam tends to break down quicker over time. So the fact that this guy has been sitting around for at least 6 months, probably more, in this cheap foam is what had me worried. Now, the box with the horse in it did look like it had some paint rub off on the foam itself, but looking at it, I can't really see that it affected the statue. Looked like it was somewhere along his hind quarters. Yeah, and I can't really see that. So some of the foam though is sitting deep in the grooves. I'm kind of having to use my brush a little bit more. I wouldn't advise using compressed air on your statues. Might make it a little bit easier, but sometimes you get that cold liquid that squirts out of the bottle and you don't want to rub off any of the paint or take any chances. So just have some patience, use your brush. I've seen some little blowers, you know, that would be handy. If I were to go out and get my electric leaf blower from outside and bring it in here and blow this guy off, that might be a good idea. It's not too strong. It's electric, it's cheap. I blow myself in the face, my dogs, my kid with it, so it's not a big deal. But anyways, I digress. Let's get the rest of this statue out. I think I'm gonna start with Death Dealer's body here. Everything looks to be okay. Oh, wow. Even though this was the lightest of the boxes, this Death Dealer torso, body, has some good weight to it. say the horse feels heavier than the bass, and so does a Death Dealer. He feels heavier from the bass as well. So I'm going to gently sit him here and make sure not to scrape too much. He does have a peg under his hindquarters. I'm worried about that foam getting all these little crevices I can't quite get to when I'm building the statue. So he does have a peg that goes inside of the horse. Okay. Now let's see, what else do we got here? We got some strips. It's like where his feet are gonna go.
Yeah.
Strips. I think so. At this point, I don't see how they'll attach. Get the other pieces out. This is going to be his right hand. Has the crazy Death Dealer axe covered in gore. It'll snap right there. There we go. Now we got a sword. Scabbard here. Gonna have to look at some pictures, figure out where that goes exactly. We got a sword on a chain, sword and scabbard on a chain here. Figure out, look at some pictures, figure out exactly how that's gonna sit on him before I put that on. So the sword. Looks like it's gonna go up and around his back. I'm not sure it works there. Should sit right here. Maybe it should go above his arm there. All right. And we have feet. All right, we've got a right foot. And a left foot. Looks like he's got some heavy duty spurs there. Would be cool if they kind of had some gouge and blood marks there in the side of the horse. We've got a boot. Got one of these stirrups. Looks like this gold section here actually goes towards the front. And it's like they are numbered on the inside. Maybe. like they're marked on the inside to tell you which goes to which. So this foot and stirrup goes together, and then I can snap. That boot into place. So boots and stirrups are in place. I would say not the strongest magnets in the world. There's a little bit of a problem with Ares and his magnets not quite being strong enough to hold up his weapons and shield. So it looks like they did not improve the strength of the magnets here. Let's see how this tail goes on. Again, not the strongest magnet. See, there's some wobble there to the tail. And now, I think we have a shield here, right? Big ass left arm and a big ass shield. I'm wondering. Yeah, this will probably. Put that over his shoulder. There. I do wish the magnets were stronger. I'm gonna put this. Some images and see exactly how that sword is supposed to sit. You know, I don't know how they have it in pictures. It's a little bit on the strange side. They have it kind of sitting up under his, under here like that. And it looks like they have the head sitting on top. So yeah, let's give that a go. Let's try metal helmet first. Or metal horn first. Snap that right there. Yeah, I guess if he had separate chainmail on his hood, that it might sit on top of the chain there. I just don't want to scrape up that chain too much. So there is a Death Dealer on horse. Got the metal horn head first. Looks really cool. One thing you know about these ARH pieces is the paint isn't quite up to how the prototype looked. And I know that's true in every case with the statue, or most every case. So one thing about the Arion statue and this Death Dealer statue is this gold here really popped for me in their images, and I really like that contrast. And it's not quite popping like it did in the prototype pictures. So the metals and the gold is not quite popping. So this is a giant of a statue. Let's turn them around for you a little bit. Make sure that those white spots are all foam, not paint rubs. So far, I'm in the money. Spent some time getting that all off this guy. So, no breaks. Super excited for that. Aurion Death Dealer 1, no breaks. Really great heavy statue. Let's put that second head on. Just think the head I actually like better. Get some of that snow off of it. Yeah. That's the head. Just looking at the heads, that's the head I like better. Let's see if I like it actually sitting on the statue. Yeah, it looks cool. I'm not sure which head I like better now though. But so, here is a Death Dealer on horse. Let's see if you can put him next to the art itself. Now, overall quality of the statue could be a little bit higher, but the statue wasn't super expensive. The time we thought it was expensive, I think it was like around $800. We thought, oh my gosh, that's an expensive statue. But look how much statue you get for $800. If another company made this guy, he would be how much? $1,500, $2,000? So you're getting some pretty decent value. I'm just noticing some of the details here in the front of the saddle. Looks really cool. I do wish the paint would pop a little bit more with some of the golds, but when looking at the art print, it doesn't pop in the art print. I've said in my previous ARH videos that the paint isn't top quality, right? It's not bad. It's kind of in the medium level, but I think with these types of statues, I think it works because they're supposed to be gritty. They're supposed to be dirty. They're supposed to be lesser quality. When you look at the art print, it's gritty. It's not, it's ugly, right? It's gritty, it's ugly. It's not fancy. It's not perfect. It's not crisp. It's art, it's paint, right? And so you kind of get that feel and get that effect here on the statue. The horse does have some faint texturing in it. Would have been nice if that would have been done a little bit more, but I like it. I did have some rub off in my box, but I'm not seeing any paint rubs here. And I might go with that metal head. Now that the heads are on the statue, I think I might go with that metal horn head. So I do really dig this statue. I'm really liking it a lot. I think it's gonna look awesome in my collection. Planning on putting him down here with Aurion. And at some point, maybe I'll get Ares fixed up and put down there as well. But really happy, like Aurion, happy in the end that I ordered this statue. Yeah, it took a while to get here. Yeah, at times I was worried, was it even gonna come at all? Or when it did came, was it gonna be broken? But Aurion, Death Dealer, both came without any breaks, without any issues. So say what you want about ARH. I know people have varying experience with the company, but right now I am happy as a clam. Death Dealer on horse, or Death Dealer 1, number 2 of 190. This guy is awesome. Got some nice gore along his axe. He's got a real chain. A chain was trying to stick to the magnet in his head. Even though the magnets could be a little bit stronger, they do work out. Nothing is loose on here. There's no pieces that are loose. You know, they just don't snap. And I wish they had a little bit firmer hold on everything. But nothing is loose here. His arms aren't loose. His boots wiggle a tiny little bit, but that's okay. It's not like I'm worried about anything falling off. So that's good. Now, I do have to get out a snowplow when I'm done with this review and get rid of all that snow, but that's something that's time consuming, tedious, but it's not that big of a deal. Some of these foam pieces though are sticking in some of the details, so I might need to do some work with this statue, but this was a statue I've been waiting for a long time. Was highly anticipating this statue. Would have been... I got a little hair there. I don't know if that's... Certainly not for me. The hairless one. But it's probably one of my little huskies pieces of hair. Which just gets everywhere. No matter what. Even though he is rarely in this room, still he gets his hair in here. But that's just what happens. That's just what happens with huskies. So, really digging this statue. Really happy that I got it. Really excited of where he's gonna go in my collection. I think it's gonna make a great display down there. Gotta move some comic books and some junk I've been storing while waiting for him. I just had an empty spot there. I gotta put something there. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with this metal. I'm gonna go with this metal head. What do you guys and gals think? Metal head or bone head? Which one would you go with? Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think of this ARH statue. And let the other collectors know what your experiences with ARH are as well. If you wanna read about ARH Studios, you know, check out their website, post the description in the comments below. I also suggest checking out statueforum.com so you can read some reviews on the company, some reviews of their statues. Now, thanks for joining me on this episode of the Unboxing Experience. I hope you had a good time. I always have great times putting together these statues and unboxing. It's my most favorite thing in collecting, is getting to open it up and see what's inside. So if you did enjoy the show, check out our show called Statue Talk, which comes out every 2 weeks. In that show, I share with you the latest statue previews, pre-orders, and updates to my and Kwong's collection. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to check out our latest unboxings, reviews, and collection updates. And remember, statue collecting is more than just a hobby, it's a lifestyle. This has been Joe Prodzik for Statue Review. Thanks for watching. And stay tuned, I'm gonna post a couple more pictures and some video of this guy.